See.
Yeah.
You're. I have some class.
My favorite.
You know, I have a baby brother. I'm a teacher. It's not a thing. And I have 14 years. I have.
Yeah.
Which is in there. Yeah, we can use that. We don't like that. I like. Mentality. I mean, like, who isn't. You know. But I. Yeah. Okay.
I'm just telling them.
I don't know if anyone else. About that.
That's kind of what you.
I have to do. I have the chart. Christmas sound. It's on vinyl.
Yes, you can.
Okay. Let's continue working through your packet. Any questions? Page, up to page 15.
Page 13, B, part C.
Mm-hmm. So we know that there's a horizontal asymptote, which means that the graph is either going to be falling or rising towards that asymptote. And it says, right, but do not evaluate an expression involving an improper integral that represents this value of C, basically that Y value, right? So anything, you know, if we're trying to figure out what that Y value is, then we're going to be pulling the vertical components, right? And we do know, but the problem that at Y of two, the graph is at Y of two is equal to three, right? And we just have to figure out, you know, how far is the graph going to rise and fall from that point forward? And if we can know how far it's either going to rise or fall from that point forward, we can work towards where that vertical asymptote is. So we know that the vertical components with our function is with that 4t over 1 plus t cubed. So we should figure out, you know, where's the graph going to, how much is the graph going to rise from 2 to infinity with that graph, right? But we know that our anchor point is negative 3, so we're starting at negative 3, and then however much rise we're going to get out of this is going to take us towards that limits, which is the height of the horizontal asymptote. That makes sense.
So how do you know the current's going to go like that?
We know that this value is going to be a positive number. So because of that, I mean, I guess we don't have to know that it rises, or we just know that it's going to move towards that asymptote. I mean, if it's above, then it's going to go down and meet.
Right.
But we don't have to draw the graph. I drove through the graph to show that is what's happening. But ultimately, it's, we're starting at a point and we're trying to figure out how much rise or fall is that to bridge the gap from the starting point to the asymptote.
Okay.
Any other questions up to page 15? Okay, so let's continue working. Page 16.
Seven, okay, that's fine, right? We should put it. It does. We want to make sure that the exclude the function in the range of the. It's under absolute. Well, it's best. Checks. Since. Since. I think it's here there. Some days. Even since the integration on some zones. Which states well. Which do. Which is. It's not. In the. Yes. Be. Be. They like. Why you. No, I'm moving. Thank you. You should. And for some water. Yeah.
I'm just trying to find. You. Is it? It's. Oh. Oh, it's. You know. It's. What's. Thank you.
I can. It's not calculated.
Yeah.
And I just like.
Yeah, you'll leave it in this form there.
I can just leave.
Exactly. Yeah. The American value is good enough. Yeah.
Okay.
This page 17 calculator.
Yeah.
I was wondering, we'll see. Yeah, page 17 should be non-calculator. Let's see. Let me look.
the definition part of the non-calculator. Maybe you can just leave it like that. And you don't have to accept it.
Okay.
But pretty under, front part, just add it to.
Yeah, page 17 does feel a little strange for it to be non-calculator. You know, I think this is doable. Just, I mean, adding that up is not very reasonable. So if you leave it in this form, this is perfectly fine. That means the same thing as that. I think the messiness is this, right? Trying to figure out that's equal to 0.008. Again, you can leave all your answer unsimplified. So you just have all this mess on either side of. Oh, I see.
Yeah. That to simplify it to like. That doesn't equal.
I don't know. Yeah, when I look at the key from College Board, they also have those decimal values. But it's weird because it's number 4 on the AP exam. Okay, now it is an older problem. So I think once it gets up to number 6, it begins to kind of have more consistency, I think. But yeah, this does feel a little bit like a calculator question. But I think once you hit the more recent problems, we're not going to see any of these issues with the number 6 on the FRQ.
Okay.